Hi everybody. I'm almost getting used to saying, or to not saying, great to see you, thanks for coming, nice to have you here. Which I suppose is a sign of the times, but hopefully that is going to change soon. It is, however, great to be here, and I hope you're out there. A huge thank you to Ensemble Reza, not just for having me back, but for having these concerts, this concert series, and keeping live music going for people during these difficult times, which is so important. I'd like to say a few words about the Bach cello suites, generally, as well as the one I'm going to play today. This music is 300 years old, and it's amongst the most loved, listened to, enjoyed, obsessed over music that we have. It is, of course, very profound and important music, but for me it's also very human and emotional music. It's full of joy and sorrow and humour, and I think we as cellists are very lucky to have it. As I say, Bach wrote the music nearly 300 years ago, around 1717 to 1723, and he wrote six cello suites, all as Baroque dance suites, and they all take the same form and structure of a prelude followed by five or six dance movements. I say five or six because the penultimate movement of each suite is either a pair of menuets or bourrées or gavottes. And the performing tradition at the time was to play the first dance and then go on to the second, which has a very different character, and then go back and repeat the first, so you have a sort of ABA structure. So I think that makes up one movement. So the suites have a sort of journey, not just within each one, but through the whole six of them. And Bach uses more and more complex writing techniques, but more than that, he also is challenging what the instrument is possible for the instrument and is capable of. So the fifth suite that I'm going to play today calls for the top string of the cello to be tuned a whole step, a tone lower. And the sixth suite, the final suite, is actually written for a five-stringed instrument, excuse me, with an extra top E string. So the fifth suite, as I say, that I'm going to play today, has this scordatura tuning, which means retuning one of the strings. And this not only changes the pitch of that string, but I think it also changes the resonance of the whole instrument. And it gives the cello a much more dark and rich texture and sound to it. I think that's very appropriate for this particular suite, the fifth in C minor. It's, I think, probably the most sophisticated of the six suites. It's also quite a dark and somber piece. It has moments of levity, but it has a lot of introspective music in there. It starts with the prelude and then has the dance suites, the dance movements that I mentioned, the allemande, the courante, the saraband, and finally the gigue. Oh, the two gavottes that I spoke about, and then the gigue. I'm not going to talk about all of them, don't worry. I would like to say about the saraband, though, which is definitely the heart of this suite, but for me, perhaps the heart of all six of the suites as well. It's, while hopefully a very beautiful movement, I think it's also very sparse and very lonely. And perhaps that is reflected at the moment in people's situations and spirits with this terrible pandemic. So obviously I'd like to play this piece for you, for everyone, but also with a thought to anybody who has lost loved ones or livelihood, a sense of purpose, dignity, And also thinking particularly of all of our performing colleagues around the world who at the moment are unable to do what they love. Slight technical issues. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I wanted also just to say, I meant to say earlier on, a little bit about the cellos that I'm playing. I think you can see the other one. I have one more piece to play, and I'm going to use a different cello. One, because it's a practical consideration when you've tuned down the instrument, as I said, for this suite. It's not necessarily ideal to keep tuning it up and down, it unsettles the strings a bit. But also because I wanted to play a different instrument, my other cello, which has a different sound, a different quality. It's an older cello, and I thought there was something quite nice about playing a piece like the Bach that was written 300 years ago on this cello, which is my modern instrument, made by a wonderful maker called Helen Mischenschläger. And it's about 20 years old. And the other cello, which I'll go and get, is this instrument, which is over 200 years old. So I thought there was something nice about playing the next piece on today's programme, which was actually only written last year. It's a piece that I first heard online, and it's called Still, and it's an arrangement for solo cello by my colleague in America, Sube, and I got the music from her. I heard her playing it, and I thought it was very beautiful and very peaceful. It's a setting of Psalm 46, and sorry, I'll just make sure I've got the right music, and I think it's a very moving and spiritual piece, and again, I hope that it may resonate with people at these difficult times. So it just remains for me to thank you. I hope you're still out there. And also to say a big thank you to Ensemble Reza's sponsors here, without who this wouldn't be possible. So a huge thank you to the Postcode Lottery and the Sussex Community Foundation. And thank you for your sponsorship and helping this series go ahead. And as I said, keeping music live. The only other thing to say is that next week's Ensemble Reza concert, you're in for a real treat. More cello-dominated music. My great friends Pavlos and Sara will be teaming up with the ensemble, and they're playing Schubert's last chamber work at all, which is his string quintet for two cellos. It really is the most wonderful piece. So please tune in same time next Tuesday to hear that. But for now, stay safe, keep well, and this is Still by Sube.